In this video, we are going to discuss the causes, clinical signs, diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of bacterial endocarditis in dogs. The video is based on the writings of veterinary cardiologist Dr. Rebecca Egom. Endocarditis is an infection of one of the heart valves. The infection is usually by bacteria that have traveled in the bloodstream from somewhere else in the body. The bacteria attach to the valve and destroys it, which causes the valve to leak. When a valve leaks, blood flows backward in the heart. In bacterial endocarditis, the two most affected valves are the mitral and aortic valves. The mitral valve lies between the left atrium and the left ventricle. The aortic valve lies between the aorta and the left ventricle. If either of these valves leaks, the left have to handle a bigger volume of blood, so it enlarges. For a while, the ventricle can manage the extra valve, but eventually it fails and signs of left heart failure occurs. Endocarditis is uncommon in dogs and rare in cats. Bacteria from infection of the spine, prostate, lungs, bladder, and kidney, skin, teeth, and gums, and long-term intravenous catheters may affect the heart valves. Some dogs with congenital heart defects such as subaortic stenosis have abnormal heart flow in their hearts, which makes them prone to endocarditis. Many different bacteria causes endocarditis, some more common than others. Occasionally, fungal organisms can affect valves too. Bacterial endocarditis is more common in large breed dogs that are middle-aged or older. The first signs are often of infections in some parts of the body. Lameness, swollen joints, lethargy, anorexia, difficulty breathing, weakness, and collapse may occur with endocarditis. Sometimes a patient may have fever. Signs of heart failure do not develop until the disease is very advanced. If during physical examination, a new heart murmur in the patient and signs of infections are present, then bacterial endocarditis may be considered. Blood work and bacterial cultures are often done to look for infections. Blood may be submitted to test for Bartonella or other bacteria. Thoracic and abdominal radiographs are also important. Echocardiogram is needed to check the heart valve for signs of infection and leakage. Multiple blood cultures may also be needed to isolate circulating bacteria in the bloodstream. If the patient is lame and has swollen joints, radiographs of the affected legs and joint taps with the retrieval of fluid for analysis and culture also may be considered. Antibiotics are used in most dogs for at least 3 to 4 months. Ideally, the antibiotics are given intravenously for the first 1 to 2 weeks. This often requires daily visit to the veterinary hospital or prolonged hospitalization. The bacteria are protected on the valve leaflets by thickened tissues, so prolonged therapy is needed. The goal is to stop the bacteria from further damaging the valves and prevent them from leaking or prevent any leakage from worsening. If the patient is showing signs of moderate to severe left heart failure, it may be hospitalized for stabilization. Dogs with left heart failure are very fragile and need aggressive treatment with as little stress as possible. Blood cultures are often repeated 2 to 3 weeks after starting antibiotics and again 1 to 2 weeks after stopping antibiotics. An echocardiogram may be repeated 1 to 2 weeks after starting antibiotics, 4 weeks into therapy, and 2 to 3 weeks after stopping antibiotics. Dogs in left-sided heart failure often require more intensive monitoring with frequent recheck visits, radiographs, and laboratory tests until they are stable. If the bacterial endocarditis is caused by Bartonella, a blood titer may be repeated 1 month after starting antibiotics. As a method of prevention of bacterial endocarditis, it is recommended to begin the use of antibiotic orally or intravenously before a surgical or dental procedure. Prognosis is very poor for dogs with bacterial endocarditis of aortic valve, with survival times as low as 3 days. Bacterial endocarditis of mitral valve has an average survival time of 476 days. Dogs with bacterial endocarditis usually die of left-sided heart failure or die suddenly from an embolus if pieces of the infection break off and lodge in other organs. If you found this video information useful, please give us a thumbs up. By giving us a thumbs up, you are helping this information to reach other veterinarians and veterinary students in different parts of the world.